Yeah, it was really different this time around, and that was just because of COVID. So we didn't go anywhere else. We went into the village, probably later than what we'd wanted to, but with COVID, that was just the way it was. Went to the training field, came back to the village, went and played, and then left the next day. So that was hard when you want to support other people, and other team members, but it was the way it was, and it kind of then turned into like a really nice thing when like Hayden first got his first medal, and then the rowers, and then so they would come back to the village and we would celebrate them winning medals. And that hasn't been done before. Normally they go to the New Zealand house and the celebrations are done there, but like as soon as someone would send a text out, they're coming home, they've got a medal, like our whole team would be down the bottom, joining in the haka, and just built the excitement and like really like excited you to play.
I know you're talking to us on your phone, so this might be a bit small, but let's just have a look at this for people who are watching. If you're not watching, jump on stuff.co.nz or play stuff and have a look what we're talking about. This is what you're talking about, you girls coming home to the village. Check this out, people. It's fantastic.
Yeah.
I think, and I could be wrong in this, but I think I remember when Sarah Ulmer won her gold, gosh, 300 years ago, whenever that was.
She's the reason why I wanted to become an Olympic
Oh,
athlete. So,
wow.
yeah, she
Well,
is, yeah.
I think I remember when she won her gold. I'm pretty sure she came back to the village and they gave her a haka. And that was the first time I'd ever seen it. And obviously what you're saying is now, because of the situation, it's everybody. But there must, I mean, I was going to say, you know, how many times have you cried since winning the gold? Because I think there's a lot of us out there who have, you know, kind of cried 3 or 4 times since you guys and other people around you have won the gold, because it's very emotional. And this event, I'm sorry, I'm pointing there because that's where my screen is. This haka, when you get back, it's, I don't know. I used to do talk back on Newstalk ZB, and obviously, respectful to the people who listen to me, it's full of right wing rednecks, you know? And it's a lot of people of, oh, you know, marry this and marry that. But I've always sort of been of the opinion it's the Māori culture that really defines New Zealand's uniqueness. It's the one thing that we have in New Zealand. And look, I'm of Irish ancestry. I'm almost pale blue. I'm so white, you know. But it's the one thing that defines New Zealand that's different, as the literal, the one thing that defines us as different to the rest of the world. And I watch those hakas and I just go, man, if you want to get a snapshot, in my opinion, of why New Zealand is fucking awesome, just look at what's going on there. Look at what these people are doing for each other. What's it like to be in it?
Oh, heck, I've cried so many times in the last, well, I'm going to say months. Just, yeah, the haka is special to us, and that's what, like, our team is, we pride ourselves on our culture and our Māori culture, but we've got people, Tongans, Chinese, and so everything is done to respect our cultures. And then when you come into the New Zealand team, and they've really, like, I suppose expanded the culture of the New Zealand team, and so there's now that New Zealand team haka, which everyone learnt. And yeah, when you get welcomed like that, it definitely pulls at your heartstrings to really proud to be Māori, proud to be a Kiwi. And that was probably a really special one. So we got welcomed in. So Caleb from the rowing team,
Yeah.
he asked to say a speech, asked to lead the haka, and like for us is like that's what made me cry even more, that he took the time to want to do something like that for us. And yeah, it was there was quite a few tears in that haka.
Do you know why? Do you know why Caleb in particular wanted to lead that one? And he was the cox, wasn't he, in the rowing? Why he in particular wanted to lead for you guys?
So we'd met him in 2016, and he seen what happened. We seen what happened to the rowers at that stage, and so created quite a nice connection and relationship with them. And a lot of us have kept in contact with a lot of the rowers. And then when they won their silver, and then they watched us win our gold, we just again had another bond. And so he just said he really felt he needed to do that for us. And yeah, I owe a lot of respect to him.
It's too cool, eh? I was also thinking it's too cool that it goes through the team now, and this is not to say in the past there wasn't the same respect, but my understanding is a lot of the times in these bigger events, they always drag like the Sevens boys or the Sevens girls in, and like, hey, can we do one of these hakas? Can you guys come and lead it for us? But obviously you guys have gone, and I think the Sevens boys had gone when you got that haka. They'd already left, is that right?
Yeah, they were already at a hotel just waiting for us to finish.
So that means it's everybody now. Doesn't matter if you're, you know, in a rugby team who does it at all the tournaments or whatever, the whole team has got this cultural aspect which gives us that uniqueness to it. It's amazing. It's amazing.
Yeah, like even when we were practicing at one stage before Hayden came back, there was heaps of countries had come around the corner to like look to see what was going on, and then all of them videoed, and like we don't do it for that, but that signifies how special the haka really is, and what you say, it sets us apart from the rest of the world, I think.
Have you ever had that interaction at an event? Have you ever had an interaction with another athlete? I mean, it may not be the Olympics, because I'm assuming you didn't mix with Russia so much because of COVID, but have you had a reaction at Rio or at one of the events you've been at where people either ask or you explain or they talk to you about that relationship to do with a haka and how Kiwis do it?
Yeah, every single tournament we go to, it's, oh my God, you're the All Blacks. And I think that, like, with positivity, I really respect the All Blacks. So you're like, yep. And then they say, oh, the haka. And then they pretend to do the haka. And so, like, those two things signify being a Kiwi and what it means for the rest of the world, pretty much.